Hi students, once again we met to continue our class. From our last class onwards, we are discussing about distance and displacement. We are discussing about distance and displacement. So we learn what is the distance, what is the displacement, how to measure the distance, how to measure the displacement, and also so we learn by comparing the difference between the distance and displacement, which is a scalar quantity, which is a vector quantity. Such a like difference we discussed. Then now we are comparing those two. When you are measuring in a particular situation, when you are measuring in a particular situation. In our last class, what we discussed, so we discussed the distance and displacement measured, distance and displacement measured in curvilinear motion. In curvilinear motion. When a body moving in a curvilinear motion, when a body moving in a curvilinear motion. See here, let's once again we'll discuss. When a body moving in a curvilinear motion, curvilinear motion. What is a curvilinear motion? Curvilinear motion means what? The body which is moving in a curved path, which is moving in a curved path. A body which is moving in a curved path. This meaning what? Curved path. Curved path. A body which is moving in a curved path. A body which is moving in a curved path. Then you can say that body describes or moving with a curvilinear motion. Curved path, whatever the shape. Now I am taking the curved path is a semicircular. What I am saying to you? Semicircular. Semicircular path. Semicircular path means what I am taking? Half of the circle. Half of the circle. Half of the circle. So curved path. How like that curved path? See one. This is a curved path. This is a curved path. A semicircular curved path. Semicircular curved path. So with radius r. With radius r. What I'm saying? With radius r. And of course, from the center of the circle to end of the circle is same. End of the circle is same. Understand? Okay. See here what I am saying to you. With radius r, the body moving through the path. Through the path what is? A, B, C. A, B, C. The body moving from A and reaches to B and finally reaches to C, means the body moving from A to C through the B. Body moving from A to C through the B with radius r in the path of semicircle. Path of semicircle. Understand? So coming to that, we want to talk about to measure the distance covered by body when it is moving in a semicircular, means a curved path or semicircular path or half of the circle in the curved path. When the means you have to measure distance. What you have to measure? Distance. See here. Distance covered by a body. Distance covered by a body in a what a curved path. Curved path. See here. This distance is showing by S. Allow me to discuss that. Okay. And what I'm saying to you here. Distance covered by a body in a circular means curved path. What is the curved path we took? Semicircular path. Semicircular means what happened? It is a half of the circle. Half of the circle means the distance means length covered by a body around the circular path. Means what happened? It covers circumference of the circle. Circumference of the circle. We know generally what we know. See here. We know. What we know, ma? Circumference of the circumference of the circle is how much? 2 pi r. Circumference of circle is 2 pi r. Then half of the circumference of the circle, half of the circle, distance covered by a curved path through the semicircular path. Then what we may write that, see here, distance covered by a body in a curved path means in the semicircular path. What you can write, see, distance is equal to half of the circumference of a circle, circumference of the circle. Understand? See here what I'm saying. Half into circumference of the circle is a 2 pi r. So 2 cancel, we may get pi r. If r is a centimeter, we can write what a centimeter. Distance covered by a body in a curved path or in a semicircular path, how much? Pi r centimeter. Coming to that, to measure displacement, what are going to measure? Displacement. See here. Displacement covered. Displacement covered by a body in curved path. What are going to find? Displacement covered by a body in curved path. See, displacement is what we learn. Shortest distance covered by a body. Displacement is a shortest distance covered by a body. Shortest distance. It is not followed by the path. It is not followed by the path. Okay. So the difference between what are two positions, two points. So from initial point to final point. So we have to find the difference between final point to initial point to measure the displacement covered by a body. So by that, what happened? Which is the shortest path? ABC or AC? AC is the shortest path then to the ABC. So the displacement covered by body from final position to initial position, from it started 0, and so total is half less than 2r. So final position is 2r minus initial position is 0. Or otherwise, diameter is nothing as a displacement covered by a body. What you can say, diameter is equal to r plus r, so is equal to 2r centimeters. So displacement covered by a body in the semicircular path is nothing as a diameter of the circle. Okay, from that what you can write, see this, how much you can get? Displacement is equal to what you can? 2r centimeter. Because of shortest distance covered by a body, so it is equal to what we can write? Diameter is equal to displacement covered by a body. Coming to that, if radius is 7 centimeter, I'm giving radius is 7 centimeter. If radius is 7 centimeter, what about this value? Pi value is a 22/7 into r value is a 7 centimeter. 7 ones. By that, what we can get? See here, we may get distance is equal to how much? 22 centimeter. Then displacement same as displacement is equal to 2 into r is 7 centimeter. 2 sevens are 14 centimeter. This is the displacement, and this is what we can say distance. See from that, which is more means the distance is greater than to the displacement when a body moving in a curvilinear motion. Understand? We have to remember what we have to remember. The distance covered by a body is greater than, the distance is greater than to the displacement when a body is moving in a curvilinear motion. Understand? This is one example to discuss. Let's talk one more example. when a body moving in a rectilinear motion, when a body moving in a rectilinear motion, in a rectilinear motion, rectilinear motion. So the body moving in a rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion means how the body moves in a straight line. Straight line or straight path. See here what I'm saying? Rectilinear motion means the body which is moving in a straight path or straight line. Then the body describes what is rectilinear motion. Then the body moving in a rectilinear motion. So coming to that, what I'm saying, straight path. What I'm saying to you, straight path. You see, this is a straight path. Straight. So body moving from point A to B and C. See here, what I'm saying, generally I'm going to say this is a 7 centimeter, it is a 8 centimeter. Then total how much? Total 15 centimeter. 15 centimeters. See here, the body moving on a straight line path, moving in a straight line path, a straight path from A to C through the B. Understand? Then what is the distance and displacement covered by a body? Let's talk about that. Distance covered by a body. Distance covered by a body in a straight line path. In a straight line path, what happens? Total length covered by body. How much total length? 15 centimeter. Distance covered by body in a straight line path. How much? 15 centimeter. Understand where it is? Distance covered by a body. What you can write? Distance covered by a body in a straight path. In a straight path. Understand? That is a 15 centimeter length covered by a body. Then what about next thing? Displacement covered by a body. What I'm saying to you? Displacement. Displacement covered by a body in a straight line path. Displacement covered by a body in a straight line path. See, displacement is equal to so final position minus initial position. Final position is what? Total 15 centimeter. Initial position is what? Start from 0. So 15 centimeter. So displacement from this relation, what we said, what we can say from this relation, see here, distance is equal to displacement. Is it or not? Distance is equal to displacement. When the body moving in a rectilinear motion, when the body moving in straight line path, the distance covered by body is equal to the displacement covered by a body. In before example, in the before, where in curvilinear motion, in curvilinear motion, what we discussed today, distance is greater than to the, what we can say, displacement. Now in the straight line path, distance is equal to the displacement. From these two situations, okay, this is for straight line path, means curvilinear motion means what I'm saying? This is curved path, this is a straight path, rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion. So from these two situations, what we can write, see here, distance is greater and or equal to the what is displacement. Distance is greater or equal to the displacement. Understand? Distance is greater in curvilinear motion than to the displacement. Distance is equal to the displacement in a rectilinear motion. Then from the two situations we can write distance is greater equal to the greater than or equal to the displacement. Understand? See carefully. You will learn two situations. What we learn? Two situations to measure the distance and displacement. We have to remember those. It is a constant for whatever. Okay? So two situations we discussed. One is curvilinear motion, one is rectilinear motion, to measure the distance and displacement. Then we'll talk about, from that what we discussed, greater or equal. Distance is greater than to the displacement in curvilinear motion. Distance is equal to the displacement in a rectilinear motion. From that we can say greater or equal than to the displacement, which is the distance. Understand? Then one more we can talk about that, one more, which is when a body projecting upward, when a body projecting upward, see here, when a body projecting upward, projecting means thrown upward, what I am saying, thrown upward. Thrown upwards. When the body is thrown upwards, see here, this is the ground. Okay? The body is rising from here. From O. From O, alphabet O. Okay? And it is moving by projecting upwards in the straight path. About a height H. After reaching to that, the body comes back, means the body moves to down. First is moving upward. First is moving upward. After reaching to the maximum height, A, and it comes back from A to O again. It comes from A to O again. So now what I am talking to you here, see here, what is the distance covered by a body and displacement covered by the body when the body projecting upward, or when a body thrown upward, a height H. Understand? Let's talk about the distance. Distance, which is you are throwing an object. Okay. See here, distance covered by a body. Distance covered by a body. Distance means length covered by a body. Distance means length covered by a body. Means what you can say, first you are projecting upwards, up to what it reaches to the maximum height H, from O to A. Then again it is coming to the back now. Again it covers some length now. So from A to O. So to project upwards, to move upwards, it covers H distance. To move downwards, it covers one more H. Means total how much distance it covers? Two H's. Means H plus H. So two H. This H plus H, how like? OA plus AO. Because of, for ascending and descending. For ascending and descending. Ascending means to rise upwards, descending means to decrease the height. So comes down. Understand? So the distance covered body two times of the height reached by a body. Understand? Then coming to the displacement. What I'm going to say? Displacement. Displacement. Displacement is what we can write. Final position minus initial position. Final position means the body projected from zero, means from zero, and reached the maximum height, and again it came to the same position as a zero. So final position is what? Zero. Initial position also zero. Then what happened finally? Displacement is a zero. Displacement is a zero. Understand? Why displacement zero? Because of the final position of your body and initial position of your body is the same. The distance, shortest distance out of the body is the final and initial position both are same. Where it was started from, it reaches the same position. Understand? Displacement is length covered by body. How much it was? Shortest distance, the difference between the two points, two positions. So same, those two positions are same. When displacement will be zero? When the body is projecting upwards a height, h, and reaches to the same position of the projecting position, initial position. That's why displacement is a zero. The final position and initial position both are same. The distance covered by the shortest distance of the body, that's why displacement is a zero. In this condition, distance is not equal to zero. Displacement is equal to zero. In that condition, distance is not equal to zero, but what I'm saying to you, displacement is equal to zero. Understand? Yeah. See, suppose if the body covers 10 meters height, if the body covers 10 meters height, then what is the distance covered by the body? So 2 into 10 meters, so 20 meters covered, and it is same as what is zero. Understand? So distance never be equal to zero, but displacement can be zero. Distance never be equal to zero, but distance can be zero. Understand? Okay, do you have clarity on that? Okay. This is the third situation to talk to you. Understand? One is curvilinear motion, one is rectilinear motion, one is projecting upwards. Means to and fro motion, vibratory motion or oscillatory motion, such like. Understand? Coming to that. Let's talk about rotatory or circular motion. Rotatory or circular motion. Similar only the both are. That's why we'll talk about circular motion. We'll talk about circular motion. A body moving in a circular motion. Means the body moving in a circular path. Body moving in a circular path. Understand? So in a body moving in a circular path. When a body moving in a circular path, then how to measure the water? Distance and displacement. Distance and displacement. See here, this is a circular path. Means I'm showing circle to you. What I'm saying? Circle. Okay, what I'm saying to you? Circle. See here, it is consists of radius, means this is the center of the circle, and this is the radius R, and this is the radius R. Okay? A body starts to journey from this position, from A, okay? See, a body moving from A in a circular path, So from here it is starts its journey. Understand? Means when a body moving in a circular path, then what is the distance and displacement covered by a body? Distance covered by a body in a circular path. The distance covered by a body in a circular path when it finishes one revolution. I'm talking about distance covered body in one revolution. Distance covered body in one revolution around the circular path. One revolution. Okay. See here. What I'm saying to you. Distance covered by a body in a circular path, when it finishes, when it completes one revolution, the whole vision. One revolve. Okay. So see here, we finish one complete rotation or one complete revolve. Okay. What is the distance? What is the distance? So distance is equal to what you can say, it finishes one complete revolution in a circular path. So one complete circumference. One circumference. Distance for the body is nothing as a one circumference. Means what you can say, distance is equal to 2 pi, what you can say, r. 2 pi r. It is for only one revolution. One revolution. Okay? It is for only one revolution. Suppose if we finish number of revolution, if a body completes n revolution, revolves, means distance is equal to number of revolution and circumference. So what we can, 2 n pi r, or n 2 pi r, 2 n pi r, okay, number of times it finishes. Then displacement covered by a body. What I'm saying to you, displacement. Displacement. To finish one revolution, same as what we discussed before, for one revolution. For one revolve. Okay. What is the displacement covered by? See here one, the body starts a journey from A. To finish one complete revolution, what happened? It came to same as its initial position. The final position is become as the initial position to cover the shortest distance. Is it or not? So the displacement covered by a body is what is displacement covered by a body is zero. Because of the final point and initial point are both same. Where it was started, it finally reached the same of the initial position. So that's why it starts from zero, the final position came to zero. So by that what happened? Displacement becomes zero. In before situation also we discussed displacement is zero when body projected upwards. Understand? Suppose if your body finishes number of revolution. The body finishes number of revolution. What is the displacement covered by body? Displacement covered by body is equal number of revolution is a zero. So zero for what? Number of revolves. Number of revolves. Okay. So how many it may be finished, but it reaches the same portion of the initial position. The final position becomes as initial position. So displacement is a zero. So from these two situations, from to this, these two situations, what we can consider here, see here, distance is not equal to zero. Displacement is equal to zero from the two situations, before and now. When a body projecting upwards and when a body moving in a circular path, distance is not equal to zero. Displacement B can be zero. And also one more you can write, distance is always greater than to the displacement. What you can consider? Distance is always greater than to the displacement. Means what we can say, distance is greater than or equal to the what a displacement. Is it or not? Are you understand? Coming to that, one more example we'll discuss. See, do you have clear on that? See carefully. Suppose, first suppose, if radius is 7 cm. Radius is 7 cm. Distance covered body for one revolution, how much we can write? See here, distance is equal to 2 into 22 by 7 into 5 value. R is 7. 7 1 2, 7 1 2. So 2 to the 4, 44 centimeters. Then if it finishes number of revolutions, distance is equal number of revolutions. Suppose number of revolution I'm saying to you, what three revolution, revolve. Three revolution means what? L means 3, 2, 5 means 22 by 7, R is a 7. 7, 7 cancel. So 44 into 3 before the 13 centimeter. This is the way to find the distance and displacement by the different situations. To find in different situations. Understand? Are you clear about that? See carefully. Okay, one more we'll discuss then. Then see. So let's talk about that. A body or a person covers 5 meter, otherwise 4 meter length towards the north direction, towards the north direction, and 3 meter towards West direction. Then find the distance covered by a body and displacement covered by a body. See, this is the question to us. It is also one of the case, one of the situation. Before we discuss four situation, no? Such a like, one more situation. See the question, a person covered 4 meter length towards the north direction and 3 meters towards west direction. To 3 meter length towards the west direction. Then find the distance covered by a body and displacement covered by a body. Understand? First, you have to analyze the question by diagrammatical because they are talking about direction. Understand? So that's why first we must know what the India map before we learn what is the direction of those. Directions. What are the directions? This is the what? North direction. This is the south direction, this is the east direction, this is the west direction. So here what is there? Bay of Bengal is there. Here great Himalayas are there. And this side Arabian Ocean. And here Hindu Ocean. Okay. Then coming to here, what I'm saying to you, these are corners. What are those? Corners. These are corners, these are the directions. What is these are? Directions. Directions and corners. Okay, let's write the corners. We have to start by poles. We have to start from poles. Understand? Coming to, this is northeast. North. What is that? East. North east. and this is north west. North west, and this is south west. South west, and this is south east. What is this? Is south east. Understand those what students are diagrammatically to our directions corners of our India map. Okay, these should follow. Coming to that, see first where it is moving. Four person moving 4 meter. Cover 4 meter length towards the north. North is moving north now. Suppose it is a position. It is moving towards the north. How much towards the north? How much more north? How much the person covers? 4 meter towards the north. Towards the north. How much? 4 meter. How much? 4 meter. And then from the 4 meter towards the north, it took 3 meter towards the west direction. West direction. Where is the west? So this is north and the west this side. So it has to come by. So this is the west. How much? How much? How much more there? This is 3 meter. This is what? West direction. How much those? 3 meter. 3 meter. See, this is the given information to us. So how the person covered? How the person covered distance, displacement to measure by this following diagram. This following diagram. What is the shape that they given to us? See, this is a 3 meter. This is a 4 meter. Understand? So now we have to find what distance and displacement. What you have to find? Distance and displacement. See here. Distance covered by a person. Distance covered by a person is equal to what is the distance total length covered body? 4 meter, 3 meter. 4 meter, 3 meter. Total how much? 4 meter first, then 3 meter next. 7 meter he was covered. Which is that distance? 7 meter. Then displacement. What is that? Displacement. See here, what I'm saying? Distance we found. We found now. Distance we found how much? 7 meter. See here. What I'm saying to you, I'm going to write here. Distance covered by a body is equal 4 meter plus 3 meter is equal to 7 meter. Okay, then what about displacement covered by a body? Displacement covered body means here person, by a person. Okay, so displacement covered by a person is equal to, so displacement covered by a person, this is the distance covered by a person and this is a displacement covered by a person. Is it visible to you? Okay, see here, displacement covered by a person. So displacement covered, displacement is a shortest distance. Displacement is a shortest distance. Shortest distance means see here. So imagine if you give names A, B, C, and if you draw this picture, AC is the shortest distance. AC is the shortest distance. Displacement is here. What we can say? AC is the shortest distance. So shortest distance of the body is nothing as a displacement. So by retorting this drawing, we can identify by that. Means it is making right angle. Means according to Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus size square to find the displacement. So coming to that, according to Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square, AC square is a displacement. So hypotenuse square is equal to, means see here, this is what a displacement. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. Side square plus side square. AC is the shortest distance. So AC is the shortest distance is displacement. AB is what? 4 centimeters. So 4 square. And BC is 3 centimeters. So 3 centimeters. By that, what we can write? Displacement square. AC square is equal to shortest distance is a displacement. 4 square is 16. 3 square is 9. So by that, 25 we got displacement square. Then displacement is equal to displacement by remove, by transferring the square that side, it becomes square root. By removing that, we can get 5 is the perfect square for that. Okay, it is a 5 centimeter. Shortest distance is nothing as a displacement covered by body, nothing as how much? 5 centimeters. Such a diagram we can find by following those, by following such a way. Understand? See carefully how we solved the displacement. By this drawing for the right angle triangle, we are utilizing Pythagoras theorem to find the displacement covered by body by using a formula. Hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. Shortest distance only hypotenuse. So that only you have to find. So that's why I substituted to get that. So distance is a 7 meter. Displacement is a meters. No, those are okay. Meters. Okay. Distance is a 7 meter. Displacement is a 5 meter. Understand? By that we can say distance is always greater than to the displacement. Distance is always greater than to the displacement. Understand? Let's recall those. What we finish with that five situations. What are those five situations? See, situation and conclusion. Situation and conclusion. Or otherwise, we can say result. What we can say? Result. See here, first thing, in a body moving in a what is curvilinear motion? Curvilinear motion. And second thing, what I'm saying, in a body moving in a rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion. Next, third thing. What I'm saying to you, third thing. In a body moving in a, what is circular motion? Circular motion. Next, the fourth thing is what you can see, curvilinear, rectilinear, circular motion, and when a body moving in, or otherwise we can say, when a body projecting upwards, vertically upwards, body projecting vertically projecting vertically upwards. And next thing is fifth condition, when a body moving in a particular direction. So we observe, what we observe, ma, in a curvilinear motion, when a body is moving in a semicircular path or half of the circular curved path, we observe there, what we observe, see here, distance is greater than to the displacement. We observe there, distance is greater than to the displacement. Is it or not? And the rectilinear motion, when a body moving in a straight line path, what happens? When a body moving in a straight line path, so here we observe distance is equal to the displacement. Understand? And circular motion, the body moving in a circular path. In a body moving in a circular path, we observed what here? Distance, what is greater than to the displacement, we observed. Now we observed distance is not equal to zero and displacement is equal to zero. Okay, we observed there, that situation. And coming to that, what you observe in the circular motion? When a body moving in a circular path, what we observe? The distance is greater than to the displacement. At the same time, we observe distance is not equal to zero. Displacement is equal to zero. And when we are projecting a body vertically upwards, by that, what we observe here? See, we observe distance is not equal to zero. Displacement is equal to zero. And also we observe distance is greater than to the displacement. Distance is not equal to zero. Displacement is equal to zero. When a body moving in a particular direction, distance is greater than to the displacement. Understand? Observe carefully. We discussed five situations. Among five situations, distance is always greater than to the displacement. And also, we discussed distance never be equal to zero, but displacement can be zero. Understand? And also, in only one situation, what happened? The distance and displacement are equal. In what situation the both are equal? When a body moving in a straight line path, we can consider the distance and displacement both are measured in the same magnitude. Means same value. When the displacement will become zero, the position, the initial position and the final position of the body is same. When the final position and initial position of the body are equal, the final position and initial position of a body are equal, then you can say what happened? The displacement is zero. When the body moving in a circular motion or in the vertically moving upwards, what happens? The displacement will become zero. From those situations, we can write the differences of a distance and displacement. Displacement. How to write difference between distance and displacement? See here. T1, sir. Distance, displacement. First thing, definition we will write. What is the definition? The length covered by a body is nothing else as a distance. The shortest distance covered by a body is nothing else as a displacement. And next thing we will write, what? The distance is a scalar quantity. Distance is a scalar quantity because it is not following the direction. Displacement is a vector quantity. Vector quantity is following both magnitude and direction. That's why distance is showing by S without cap. Displacement showing by S small r s arrow mark cap. And coming to that, because of vector quantity we show that. And distance is measured by meters in SI system, centimeters in CJ system. Of course, displacement also measured in meters in SI system, centimeters in CJ system. Okay, and the next thing we can say that, what is the next thing? See here, distance, what? Distance never be equal to zero, but displacement can be, displacement can be zero. What we can say in this situation? Distance is always greater or equal to the displacement. Here what we can, displacement is always smaller than to the or equal to the displacement. Okay, by that situation we can compare the difference between the distance and displacement. Distance and displacement. Are you understand? Okay, this is a general topic about distance and displacement. We'll discuss some more problems on the distance and displacement to understand clearly how to solve. Understand? And also we'll learn about speed and velocity and different problems, different activities we'll discuss. See you in the next class. Have a good day to you.